So in the previous video, we have seen about how to add interior walls in our project. Now let us review adding door and windows in our existing project. So it is very simple process to add the doors and windows. So I will be go through each and every steps of adding doors and windows. So first of all, the shortcut of door is DR and window is WN. So you can click on door, and here the by default it is showing you single flush 36 by 18 inches. And before adding doors and windows, I want to point one more thing, that is, if I will go to the manage tab, additional settings, and here there is option of temporary dimension. So I would like to click on this option, and in the walls I want to display the temporary dimensions from the faces, and in the doors and windows I want to display temporary dimensions in the openings. Now what is the temporary dimensions? In the Revit, whenever you will be select any element, it will be displays both dimensions. It will be displays the reference dimensions from both sides, from left side, right side, from top, bottom, from all the references. So these dimensions are called as a temporary dimension. So let us say if I will be go to the wall, and let us say if I will be have a rectangular wall, and if I will be select this wall, notice that this wall is located at a distance of 10 foot 6 and 6 point something inches. So let's say if I will use 6 foot. So as you can see, this wall is now located 6 foot from this wall. So these are the temporary dimension. And if you want to make your temporary dimension to permanent dimension, so you can simply click on this icon. So make this temporary dimension to the permanent. So as you can see, now if you will be double click or double escape, as you can see, that dimension will be retained as it is. Or if you want to give the dimension, then you can use the dimensioning, that is DI, and or alternatively you can go to the annotate tab, the first command, that is dimension align. So first step, second, third, and let us see if you want to make equalize. So this is your equalize. Now what is the power of equalize? If you will be select this wall, and if you will be move this wall, let's say about 30 feet, so notice that the center wall has been also changed because of the power of the equality. Now if you will be select this and say delete and say unconstrained, and now if you will be changing to the this wall, let's say from this point, click and drag, and let's say instead of 30 feet, let's say 40 feet, nothing will be happen to this wall. So this is all about the power of Revit, that is bidirectional associativity. Now let us go to the architecture tab, door, and we will load the family. But before load the family, make sure tail mount placement should be turned on, so that whenever you will be placed the door, it will be shows you the adding of that door as well. So click on load family, and you will be use English Imperial. Go to the default door family commercial folder, and let us I will be use door exterior double. And let us, I will be use 84 inches by 84 inches. Now this door I want to place exactly center point of this wall. So to find the exact center point, as you can see, now it is display from both sides 4 feet 5 by 32 inches. So that is okay. Or you can alternatively type SM, snap to midpoint, so it will be exactly snapping to the midpoint. And you can also flip the orientation of the door by moving the mouse top and bottom and click. Okay, now we will add the door. So DR, and we will use single flush 36 by 84 inch, and I want to click somewhere about here. Notice that here mark number is displayed as a 2, but I want to display the mark number as a 101, and click on apply. Here I want to display mark number as 100. So as you can see from the properties, or from here you can change your mark as well. This mark is displayed just because of the tier 1 placement has been turned off. If this option has been turned off, then the mark will not be displayed. So make sure you will be turned on the tier 1 placement. Now I will select this tool, and let's say I want this tool at distance of 8 inches. So how to type 8 inches? Directly you can type 8 inches, or you can type 0 space 8, so it will be use 8 inches. Now select this and make a copy multiple constraint from this point all the way to the location. Now notice that in the copied doors and windows, the tagging has not been displayed. So what we need to do, we need to go to the annotate tab, and here there is option tag all that are not tagged. If you will be click on this option, here as you can see door tags has been select. You have to select door tag and click on OK. So all the doors are now has been. Similarly, I want to add the doors in the second level. So I will be go to the second level, and I want to add the door somewhere about here. So go to use the door command. Obviously, you can go to the door family, and you can use any one of the type. Thus, I want to use something different type. That is commercial double flush passage, and let us I want to use the type that is 68 inches by 80 inches and click somewhere about here. Now notice that here the doors are not displaced properly. Door is not displaced properly. So what I want to do? So I will be go to the modify tab and use the align command. This is my reference point, and this is my target which we want to align to the reference and make it lock. So if the reference plane has been moved, then the location of the door has been moved automatically. Similarly, I want to go to the level 1, and we want to add the windows. To go to the window, and I want to use the default window that is face, and obviously you can go to the tier 1 placement turn on, go to the load family and go to the windows folder, and you can use any one of the windows from this list as well. I want to use the default, and I want to place the window exactly in center, so SM as you can see. Now click again SM, click, notice that your location of the window should be outside. Okay, so now I will be select all the windows. Pressing the control key, select interior walls and doors, select this door, and now I want to do the mirror. Notice that 11 items has been selected. If you want to filter, you can filter the item from here as well. Now what are the items has been selected? Doors, walls, windows, door tag and window tag. If you want to deselect any one of the item from this list, you can simply uncheck on that item and you can simply click on OK. Now let us verbally use mirror pick axis. Okay, you can also use mirror draw axis and you can draw a line as well. So as you can see, one of the door has been mirrored by using mirror draw axis. And mirror pick axis, that means you have to pick your reference. So I want to pick the reference of this reference plane. Notice that all items has been mirrored properly, doors and windows. Now in the next video, we will see about adding the floor.